I've waited 28 years for this. Now, I don't mean clean up the chrome or anything like that. I mean actually getting a BMX. I just thought I'd slide this little trial into the video. Normally when I'm cleaning up the chrome, like rims and handlebars, whatever, I end up using a bit of WD-40 and some wire wool. Does the job, gets it clean, and if it's fine enough, it doesn't tend to scratch it. But what I've seen on the old tinterwebs is that if you take a bit of aluminium foil or tin foil, whatever you want to call it, and a bit of water, just scrunch it up and rub it over the chrome, it will clean the rust right off it. So I haven't tried it before. I've got this rim off the rear rim off the BMX. It's got a bit of pitting, as you can see. It is dirty, so we'll see how it cleans it up, and yeah, we'll see how it cleans it up. Apparently it works because I've heard it works because the foil is softer than the chrome, so it works as an abrasive and takes the, I guess, fine parts. It ain't going to work on any heavy parts. Fine parts will rust off while leaving the chrome intact. I've also heard that it has some sort of reaction, like the aluminium reacts with it and then creates a layer, but I'm not too sure about that. So yeah, let's give it a go. And dip it in a bit of wool water. Picked a spot that did have fairly big rust spots on it, further around the rim. I mean, you might see some light spots. The rim is just dirty in general, but this is the spot that I cleaned up, and it only works at scraping off the discoloration, the general dirt and grime. And it does leave some faint scratches. You can see there is some scratches in the chrome now. That wasn't there before. So it does leave some faint scratches. Have I cleaned that part? Don't think I've cleaned that part. But yeah. I mean, it's all right for cleaning, but I'd still prefer to use the wire wool. Soft wire wool personally, with a bit of WD-40. It's just easier to manipulate around the spokes. But I mean, it was worth a go. It was worth a shot. It does clean, it just doesn't do as good a job as I expected. So I'm just gonna finish cleaning this rim up a little bit more. Try not to make too much noise with the tin foil. But yeah, my BMX. Never in my life before have I ridden a BMX. Kind of always fancied one. But it wasn't until earlier this year that I actually decided to go and buy myself one. I didn't go for a modern one or a rare rally burner or anything like that, but I did go sort of vintage. I had a look around eBay, saw what was around, and came across this chrome, fully chrome with blue detailing, West German BMX. It took a bit of research to find out what it actually was, because the badge literally just had a K on it and said made in West Germany. So it was that, pre-1989? Hope I got that right. So I just had this badge to go on, this rough date. Eventually found out it's a company called Kalkoff. Now doing a bit of search on them, they're regarded as a bit of a bargain basement brand, I guess. A bit of a Apollo, I guess, something like that. A store brand. It's not a brand that I should expect any quality from. It's a heavy bike. It's 14 kilos roughly, maybe a bit more. Whereas like a modern BMX would be like 10, maybe less. And it's made of solid gas pipe steel. It's not in too bad condition. The chrome's cleaned up fairly well. I've put new cables on it, new tyres on it, new tubes, and new chain and pedals as well. I like the seat on it. It's a plastic cell rail seat, I believe. I think. Yeah, why did I buy it? I think I bought it just purely because there's a BMX track down the road from me and I wanted to give it a go. I haven't spent too much money on it, so it hasn't been too much of an investment. But it's been quite fun. Tell you what though, the pump track is a lot more physical than it looks. First few times round, it's a short course, like it's few hundred meters. First few times round it and I was knackered. I was out of breath, huffing and puffing at the end of it, because it just works so much more than I was used to, or different muscle groups than I was used to. So I've never ridden a BMX before this point anyway. I'm going to put in some footage from when I first started going down the track. My technique is utterly terrible. I don't know how to manual. I roughly know how to bunny hop, but I can't do anything big or anything like that. So I've got a lot to learn. And hopefully this BMX will help me. Stripping it down and greasing it up and everything like that. I have learnt a thing or two about BMXs already. I didn't know until I stripped it down that they were a one-piece crank. I mean, before this, I've just been working on like the vintage road bikes, so they've all had a three-piece crank, two crank arms and an axle. But the BMX has a complete one-piece crank. I didn't know either that, well, this BMX at least, has a skinnier rear tyre than a front tyre. To me, it would have been the other way around, but apparently the wide front tyre helps with grip into the turns and helps level the BMX out in the air. This is my first BMX then. What are we going to say? 80s Kalkoff BMX. Loop tail, fully chrome, blue detailing. I'm just going to have a bit of fun on it, to be honest. It's heavy and hard work, but the few times that I've been over the pump track, it's been quite fun. Call it an early midlife. Call it an early midlife crisis. Any tips you've got to give me for this whole BMX in my life? Just leave a comment. Yeah, thanks for watching. Tin foil definitely scratches chrome.